Padma opens an application on her computer. An interrupt is generated to inform the central processing unit that the application has been opened. Question A says, give three other examples of when an interrupt signal could be generated. An interrupt signal is a signal that is generated by a device or by software to let the CPU know that something needs to be processed. An example we could use is if we're trying to print a document using a printer. The CPU is going to send data over to our printer to be printed. Whilst the printer is printing the documents, there are a number of things that could happen that stop the printer from functioning. We could have a paper jam, the printer could run out of paper, or the printer could run out of ink. All three of these errors require the user to do something. So how do we let the user know that something must be done? Well, the printer is going to generate an interrupt signal, which contains the information about what error has happened. This interrupt signal is going to be sent from the printer over to the CPU, and the CPU will then service this interrupt. In this case, it'll show an error message on the screen, which lets the user know that there has been a paper jam or the printer has run out of paper or ink. There are many different types of interrupts, not necessarily just from printers. Interrupts can also be generated from peripherals, such as keyboards, mouses, and other similar peripherals. Interrupts can also be generated by software, such as switching applications using the Alt-Tab shortcut or the shortcut Control-Alt-Delete, which interrupts all running processes. Let's go ahead and write some of these into our answer. Printer runs out of ink, mouse button click, and switching between applications. Question B says, state what would happen if interrupt signals were not used in a computer. The main reason interrupts are generated is to tell the processor that something needs its attention. For example, if the CPU is currently running a process and we perform an Alt-Tab or a mouse click or a Control-Alt-Delete, we must wait until the CPU has finished executing the current process before servicing whatever action we've just done. This could be quite inefficient because things like mouse clicks or Alt-Tabs could take a while to respond and our CPU would have a slower performance. Interrupts are also generated by software. If we open up a new application, the CPU needs to immediately start processing that application. If there was no interrupt generated by a printer when the printer had run out of paper, the user would never know unless they looked at the printer. This would be pretty inefficient. So let's write down two answers, even though this is just for one mark. The first thing we could say is that the computer cannot multitask. We could also say that errors may not be dealt with. You only need to put one of these points since this is only for one mark. The next question says, computer systems often use interrupts. Five statements are given about interrupts. Tick to show if each statement is true or false. The first statement, interrupts can be hardware-based or software-based. We've shown an example where an interrupt is generated by a peripheral or a piece of hardware. And we've shown an example where interrupts have been generated from software. So this is true. Interrupts are handled by the operating system. The operating system is in charge of every single action the CPU takes. Interrupts are part of those actions, so this is true. The next statement says, interrupts allow a computer to multitask. Given the answer to this question, this would also be true. Interrupts work out which program to give priority to. Interrupts themselves don't do any calculation. They're simply just messages. Messages can't do any sort of processing, meaning this would be false. The next statement says, interrupts are vital to a computer and it cannot function without them. That is also true. And there we go. We have this question finished.